we check out the spooky but not scary Brick or Treat at Legoland California Resort.
Then we head to Universal Orlando for a lights-on tour of a Halloween Horror Nights house.
Plus the latest theme park news and more coming at you from the attraction studio at Give Kids the World Village
right now.
Welcome to this week's episode of the show. I'm Alisa.
And I'm Quinn.
So we've got Halloween in the middle of Halloween right now. And then pretty soon it's going to be the Christmas season.
And I know we already got a look at what the Toy Story Land characters and the area is going to look like a little bit during the Christmas season. So
yeah,
that's going to be fun.
The characters are going to have adorable overlays and, you know, we love the holidays. We live for it.
We have a million holiday things coming up, but we got to finish Halloween first.
Tis the season, right? All right. We'll be right back after a message from our sponsors. You can play, stay, and dine at Walt Disney World and save up to $500 with MouseFan Travel. For a free quote with no obligation, visit mousefantravel.com.
For a limited time, you can purchase Walt Disney World tickets with no required start date using Undercover Tourist. For the best theme park ticket deals, visit undercovertourist.com.
This news in the queue starts at Walt Disney World as their new date-based pricing system has rolled out across the resort.
This new vacation planning website features ticket prices that will be less expensive during slow seasons and higher during peak times of the year to help alleviate crowds.
This new system has also introduced an increase in annual pass prices as well as guest parking prices.
This is something we've talked about a little bit before, and it's in effect now. It's here. I still saw people on Twitter and things being like, oh my gosh, I can't believe they did this, even though we talked about it forever ago.
And it's still a hard hit every time it does happen. And it's stinky. It's, you know, I'm a pass holder, so I gotta raise my prices too. So it's not fun. However, it's inevitable.
Yeah. So it's the way of the world.
Y'all know those things. Yeah.
Next, we head over to Disney's Hollywood Studios to dance, sing, and play as the Disney Junior Dance Party will make its debut on December 22nd.
This new live show will feature high-energy songs, live performers, and meet-and-greet characters from many favorite Disney Junior shows.
The new show takes place in the former Disney Junior offering, Disney Junior Live on Stage.
I love Disney Junior Live on Stage, so I'm a little hesitant about the new show, but I'll give it a chance.
It's a transition over from the little puppets, and now it's going to be, like, they're giant.
Right.
Like, it's kind of weird to see, like, Doc McStuffins, like, this big, and then suddenly she's like, hey!
Well, the actual Doc McStuffins, hello.
Yeah, but sure, you're right.
Yeah, I know. We loved the puppets, but, you know, new things, so we got to give it a chance.
It's a week for new things.
Yeah, I guess so. Legoland Florida Resort has given us the first look at the three new attractions that will be a part of the park's new area, the Lego Movie World.
Guests young and old will be able to take flight on Emmett's triple-decker couch on the Lego Movie Masters of Flight, drop from the sky on Unikitty's Disco Drop, and go head-to-head against Duplo aliens on the Battle of Bricksburg.
The Lego Movie World is set to open at Legoland Florida Resort in early spring next year.
It looks like the Battle of Bricksburg is a retrofit of Was it Chima? The Chima ride that was there before, because it looks like the same water boat sort of thing.
Yeah. I mean, I do love the theming. I love the Lego movie. A lot of people, young and old, can relate to it. So I think it'll be a really good expansion for that park to get.
And then we get to ride on the little couch, you know?
Ooh.
Or big couch.
Yeah.
Lastly, we head over to Disneyland for some news of a cancellation.
The previously announced Four Diamond Disney Hotel has officially been canceled.
Plans for constructing the hotel had recently been put on hold due to complications with the Anaheim City Council.
There's no word on what this means for the businesses at the downtown Disney District that were closed in preparation for the new hotel.
At least they got back Earl a sandwich, right?
They got back Earl, so that's a win in my book.
I agree. I think that either it will have made way for new things that weren't previously planned, or things will come back. And either way...
Yeah, I don't doubt that there's more work coming down the line
resorts.
So
when there's a cancellation, it just brings room for innovation.
I like that.
It's time to play big with the new Fall 2018 issue of Attractions Magazine. Head into Andy's backyard for a look inside the now-open Toy Story Land. Learn details about the new Evermore Park, a theme park like no other. Read all about the newest place to stay at Universal Orlando, Aventura Hotel. Plus the latest news, rumors, and more packed into every issue. Get your copy and subscribe today at attractionsmagazine.com in print or digital in our app on Nook and Kindle.
Have you ever wondered what all these haunted houses look like without all the spooky lighting and scare actors?
Oh, for sure, especially some of the Halloween Horror Nights original houses. Half of the experience is the environment.
Mm-hmm. Well, we got to send Patrick out to Universal Studios Florida to check out all the Easter eggs in Carnival Graveyard.
Over to you, Patrick.
Hey guys, I'm here at Universal Orlando Resort, standing in front of Carnival Graveyard here for Halloween Horror Nights 28. Now I'm with show director Charles Gray, and you're gonna tell me a little bit about what is going on behind us.
Absolutely. About a year ago, we started creating this, and now it's here. We're standing in it. It's amazing. It's absolutely full of tons of decor and lots of scary characters.
Yeah, I think that's crazy that even when one Horror Nights ends, you're already thinking about the next Horror Nights. So this is already a year in development, and here we are.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, now there are some special Easter eggs that I know throughout this house.
You want to go check them out?
I want to go check it out.
Well, let's go.
So one of my favorite things about Horror Nights is the original houses. So how did you guys come up with this original idea?
Actually, this is two ideas that were smashed together. We had one idea of a junkyard. Mm-hmm. And then we had another idea of evil carnies. And we were like, well, what if instead of a junkyard, we actually had a salvage yard with all old roller coasters and rides and games. And then it's ruled and inhabited by these evil carnies that are hunting us down. And once we put those two ideas together, it was golden.
As you casually come up with the twisted minds here at Horror Nights. So there are any fun props around here?
Absolutely. You can see that skull right up there. Mm-hmm. That was in the streets last year. That was representative of our event last year. And we create, here's one of the fun things about this too, is like if you look around, you see all the rust, things are ripped and torn and really kind of broken down. We actually create them brand new. Mm-hmm. And then the amount of work that goes into making something look terrible is amazing. It always baffles me.
And it's incredible the amount of detail. Like as you walk through the event at night, of course, people are running through, people are crying and hiding some, so you don't get to see the amount of detail that goes into all of these houses unless you do something like the Unmasking the Horror Tour.
Absolutely, Unmasking the Horror Tour is awesome. It gives you an opportunity with the lights on to see all the detail as you go through. Not only that, but we also include your guide will just know all these little tidbits as you come through. And of course, it's a smaller group, so mm-hmm. you get a lot of that. You have the ability to ask questions, and for the fans, that's huge.
Yeah, definitely a fun
time.
I want
to show you this. This is a lot of fun. This is like a classic game that you would find. These are called punks, and you know, you get the ball, you throw them, you knock them over, you win a prize. Mm-hmm. Well, in this one, the prize is we have one of our carnies who uses that as a door. So we like to hide doors to scare you. Also, right behind you over here, and don't tell everybody about this. This is a secret. This is what we call a GAT. It's a guest-activated trigger. So if somebody hits this, water will squirt from this lady's mouth and onto your friend.
Amazing.
Yes. Something that's interesting, too, is we like to explore heights mm-hmm. and different angles. So we have somebody coming up from up here around the corner, and it's a blind corner here so they can attack you at a really steep angle. Which always, you know, people are flying through this section right here.
Yeah, you never really look up or down.
Usually, a lot of times we'll have like maybe an 8-foot to 10-foot to 12-foot wall. In this house alone, everything is built to look up. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times we're trying to keep everybody's focus down and around you. This is kind of an experimental house where we like to build things up. In the later scenes, you'll actually be able to see.
Yeah, there's some couple signs up
there. That sign right up there. Crazy Crash, mm-hmm. you're going to encounter that sign about five different times.
Oh, wow.
In this. This is an Easter egg right here. Not all people have recognized this one as we've gone through. This is Jack the Clown. We hid that one right here. And that's from Giggles and Gore. We had it in HHN 24. Not a lot of people know this. We like to have the decor team likes to have play tricks on people.
As you do.
Throw the unexpected in there. We have the pet alligator in the ball pen. I would guarantee you most people do not see something like this. But he has his gator food over here. And the character that comes out here, Blade, that's his pet. Mm-hmm. That's his pet. So But these are the little details that you could see on an unmasking
tour. Definitely.
So the idea behind this room is we have all these broken down animatronics, but as you're coming in, the energy is pulsing from a brownout and it activates these. So some of these come to life.
Wow.
And as you're noticing, there's a clown that stands up there that comes to life, breaks, and falls on top of you.
Amazing. Again, the heights. Gotta keep your eyes up on this one.
So this scene right here we call traps. There's three different traps. The first one you're walking through here are these the strike hammers mm-hmm. that they've put together, fashioned together, and then they bang down on top of you. You have to walk underneath this forklift that, as you can see, smashes people.
As
always a good time. Fun times. And then the third trap, and this is a little bit of an Easter egg for fans who've been to the event in years past, decades past, I should say. We're inside the steel cage, and these walls raise and fall and smash. This idea was used back when we had a house called Zap.
Oh, yes.
With zombies.
Zombies,
yep. Mm-hmm. So we created these traps, this one specifically, remembering years past. This is called SIF. It stands for stuff in your face. Stuff in your face. Especially this stuff, it freaks people out when it tickles their neck and they walk through. Here's another gat. This is what I like to call I told you so. So what will happen is somebody pushes this. They maybe push the first gat, right?
Mm-hmm.
They push this one, and instead of it getting their friend, it gets them.
Perfect.
It's kind of a little lesson learned in friendship.
So I noticed in this room there's some tributes to some usual Universal rides and some past Horror Nights.
Absolutely. So Run, this is one of our own IPs. Mm-hmm. We've had the Run House three different iterations, I believe. So that's from that. Over here we have the ice cream from Vamp 55. And down there, one of my favorite shows of the past, Disaster.
So what are we standing in here?
Well, we're in between two different scenes. Right here is where the character Little Devil comes out. Kind of has that old-timey talk. He's like, I'll get you, see? So this pallet rack's interesting because it's kind of the center of the maze. And again, we encounter this pallet rack when we came out of that scene.
Yeah.
We come through here. We encounter it again. We go through the garage and then exit, and then we encounter it for a third time. Again, this is one of those moments where it feels wide open, yet we're controlling your space and how you work your way through it. We'll encounter the generator in a second, but everything, you can see these power lines as they come through, all line up, that transformer there, all goes to that generator. And so things are kind of browning out, power surging. They even are using the battery of the truck because they don't have enough juice.
Now it looks like we're in like an auto repair shop, kind of.
Basically, this is like their home base is where all the executives live. Ernest Lee, who's like the leader of the group,
mm-hmm.
he's right up there. He pulls his barrel back, lets it go, and it clangs over top of your head. So you see the barrel flying towards you as you come in. That's a really cool character. And speaking of characters, each one in this house is their own individual.
It sounds like everyone has their own different personalities. How do you guys follow up with that? How does everyone know what backstory or personality they have?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes if we're doing other houses, it's kind of a blanket. Hey, you're a serial killer or you're a clown or whatever it might be. But in this specific house, we named each character, each location. They're all individuals. And so I wrote a backstory for each one of the characters.
Oh, wow.
And so it's a few pages long, and it's kind of like a Game of Thrones where, you know, Ernest Lee used to be in love with this one and they killed this character and these two team up, and you know, it's like this very complicated backstory, but
yeah.
I think the characters really enjoyed it. I enjoyed writing it, and it just gives a lot more meat to the soup, if you will.
Yeah, a lot of depth to their character.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's awesome. All right, so it looks like we're in front of another large facade in this house. What is this?
This is the Love Shack. Now, the first third was a lot of about the games, the rides. We go into the garage where they repair things. These last two scenes are things that you would see in an old-time fair or carnival. The Tunnel of Love is always a big thing, right?
Oh, yeah.
So we have the Love Shack here, which is a lot of fun. One of the most interesting tidbits about this room is you'll see a cherub, two cherubs that mm-hmm. are painted on the wall. Those are both the designers of the house. There's Nick Collins. So one of the cherubs is up there. I think that was a practical joke, but it's hilarious. And then there's a song that plays in there.
Mm-hmm.
And Anthony Smith, who's one of our audio techs, and myself wrote the song that goes in the Love Shack. So you hear this old-timey music playing, and then these two characters come out, and they've skinned people's faces, trespassers, put them on themselves, and then they come out and they actually kiss in the tunnel of love. It's very, very creepy.
Yeah. Who doesn't love a twisted love, Shaq?
Those are just the kind of details you'd never see. You know what I mean? It's just very random and creepy, but when the lights are on, then you notice,
like,
those kind of things.
Those are just baby heads.
And
no
then
big deal.
The trespassers over here, this is like a human mirror ball. So they've taken off their faces. This is spinning around like a mirror ball, and then the two characters, Chester and Alma, come out, and they're wearing their faces. Mm-hmm. And of course, love's first kiss happens right here.
That backstory is one I don't need to know. So with a house like this, obviously there's so much going on, and a lot of them are tribute to the parks, but where do you find all this junk?
Very well-placed junk, yes. It's, twofold. One, we actually have somebody in decor that's like a buyer. So he went out and he scoured the area. There's actually some amusement park salvage yards that exist in Florida. So he went digging through those places. Along with some of this stuff we keep in storage. Year after year, we'll bring back some of these pieces, if it's appropriate. And then at the end of the year, we kind of go through and see what we want to keep. That crow right there, we used to place crows in different houses. For example, this was in Ghost Town, the Lightning mm-hmm. Gulch. So just these random little pieces. This right here was in an IP the other year. So just bits and pieces that we find. This wagon's been used before. And again, even the bodies. That's something that's fascinating too. We have like a body that'll be pristine. We buy it brand new as a victim body, and then the next year it's missing an arm, and then the year after that it's got a hole in its chest. So it just kind of degrades, and finally it's just bits and parts of the body, but they each have their own lifespan.
Now this seems almost like a fun house.
Yes, exactly. This is like one of those UV dark ride fun houses and this is the finale. So the story is that the worst of the worst of the carnies are living back here. So even the ones that are a danger to the rest of them, they throw them in here. So as you're coming through in this finale, it gets very dangerous in here. We have a little bit of a mirror maze, warped mirrors are coming out. One of my favorite characters, who's very disturbing, is right here. And he's actually hiding behind this wall. So as you're walking forward, he's right here, and then he just comes around and attacks. And he has like this, almost like an animated character's bunny ears, and it's as if he grabbed somebody and scalped them while they were an animated character and then put that over his head. Big hulking guy. So again, you're attacked from right, for left. You don't know all the directions are coming at you. Got the UV treatment, very classic looking here. And this is where the twins, Cora and Dora, are, and they're like the once beautiful girls who have now aged, and they're angry, and they've like mutilated themselves trying to look pretty, and they're disgusting in here. Yeah, but they have like these slide doors here so they can attack you from two different areas. So they can attack from here, there, so you're getting four.
Both sides.
Yep, on both sides. So it is a gauntlet of terror. As you exit the house, you're greeted by this. This is actually kind of, was a surprise to me, actually. Sometimes decor will go above and beyond. They will just do amazing things. And I walked out. This is one of the first houses I worked on in the event, Dollhouse of the Damned, and that finale was right here. Just that creepy baby head as we come out. And I remember walking out and being like, oh my gosh, I remember. So it's like these old friends, you know?
Definitely another tribute to fans of HHN as well.
Absolutely. So the unmasking, the horror, you get to see it, the detail, where it lives, where it's at. Make sure you guys come check it out.
Yeah, I definitely say if you are a big Horror Nights fan, you want to see all the details you don't normally see, definitely check out the Unmasking the Horror Tour. Thank you again, Charles. This has been a blast. Twisted blast.
Yes.
But it's been fun.
I think each and every one of us goes above and beyond. We do everything for our clients that we could possibly do. From getting up at 3 a.m. to get the best deal for them when it comes out, to staying up late at night to send them their documents. We like taking the stress off of you. We'll stress about it. You go have fun.
MEI and MouseFan Travel is your expert source for no-fee travel planning. Visit MEI-travel.com for a no-obligation quote today.
Skip the lines with undercover tourists, crowd calendars, touring plans, and mobile apps. Stop paying full price for your family vacation and visit undercover tourists today.
The sweetest Halloween event that's built for kids is back at Legoland for the spooky season.
That's right, and we got our kid reporter Linda Lee to check it out at Legoland, California.
Save some candy for us.
And this year, it's bigger, spookier, and sweeter.
That's right. There's more fun things to see and do. Plus, there's more trick-or-treat stations than ever before.
Lindley, I think you mean brick-or-treat stations. I mean, don't forget where we're at.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, let's stop standing here talking about it. Let's
go. So it's already 5:30 and the park closes at 9. So we gotta get moving. There are 16 candy stations and we gotta get them all. Also, these are the candy corns. That means the candy stations. Shows for the little happy sad icon. And this is for treats, seasonal treats. And right now we're here and we gotta hit all of them while doing rides. Okay,
yeah.
Do you think we can do that?
Yeah, we are gonna try so hard. And peeps at home, keep track, please.
Okay. Let's go.
Hey guys.
Oh, these are bags.
Yeah, how many?
We just have bags.
Sea life.
Oh, sea life. Yeah, let's go here. Come on.
Spider. Oh my god.
Oh my gosh, there's a slide.
Abigail, go. Linda Lee, go. Leopard shark, my favorite.
Gorgeous.
Are eating pumpkins right now, and apparently they like them. Millions of sharks are hard.
Look up, look up, look up. Oh!
I like your treat. Thank you. It's again, Sour Patch. We found it. Hey, we just got recognized from last year's video.
Yeah, they were so sweet.
Oh my god, and they were so cute. Because it was a huge aquarium. So we are heading over to Heart Lake City and there is some trick-or-treat stations. There we go. Yay!
Do you know where the next candy station is?
There's one right there.
Number three. Trick-or-treat.
Trick-or-treat.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, you guys. We're actually going to station 4.
Yes.
Trick-or-treat.
Trick-or-treat.
Thank you. Okay.
We're going to say hi to some Lego friends.
I remember you. You have a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Look at who we ran into. Some of the Lego friends in Heart Lake City.
Hi.
It was nice talking to you.
Nice to see you.
Bye. Bye. Hey, guys, don't mind us, but we're just checking out the awesome rock and roll bands.
This is number 5. Trick or treat.
Trick or treat. Does this count as a treat station or no?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a trick or treat Lego.
Station?
There's one right there.
Okay, thank you. Candy station.
Yes, I knew it. It's our station. It's our Smarty station.
Trick or treat.
Treat. Thank you.
You got a lot of Smarties. Where's the next station?
Hi, follow me, everybody. It's all so scary. Help me, Abigail. Flossing the bubbles. Bubba Potty.
Wait, trick or treat.
Look at all my Twizzlers. She is so much. Oh my gosh.
It's like Twizzler heaven in here.
Thank you. Okay, so 9.
His costume is so amazing. It's so creepy and fun. What's your favorite candy?
Smarties, yay, yes. You're part of our squad. It's been a long year since we've gone to Brick or Treat together. So what have you been working on for this past year?
Well, thank you for asking. I've been working on Better Call Saul and also a couple other Disney projects, but I can't say the names just yet.
And weren't you just on a This Is Us episode?
Yeah, I was on one episode.
Yeah, I saw that.
What have you been working on lately?
Press junkets, conventions, premieres, that stuff, you know.
Good beans.
Right over here at the, oh, right here.
So we've gone to 9 candy stations.
See?
So
boom!
Far. Perfect.
Trick or treat.
Oh, here you guys go. Some candy for
you. Thank you.
Yep. Happy
Thank
Halloween.
You.
You too.
Ten stations. Oh my gosh.
We need six
and we
more.
We have 2 hours left, literally. It's only 7:15.
Oh, right there.
Yes! Oh my God! This is number 11.
11.
11. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're gonna do this thing. So we just like did all the Pirate Land things, and now we gotta head over to Castle Hill. You guys, this is gonna be our 12th candy station. Let's go. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Can I just have lollipops, please?
Sure.
Brick or treat. Thank you. Let's do it. Oh my gosh, you guys, 13.
Trick or treat.
And what is your name?
DJ Marshmallow.
DJ Marshmallow?
Yes.
Yeah,
DJ
Marshmallow.
Go Marshmallow.
And let's give them a big round of applause.
Strike up. Oh.
Okay, so we are here with Julian, and she works for Brick or Treat, and it is, like, so awesome to see you again. Third year. Amazing. How are you?
Good, thanks for coming back. I'm so excited to have you back, Linda Lee. Have you guys seen any shows yet?
Yeah, we just saw the costume show. We actually saw a couple.
Awesome, well, I'm excited because we have brand new shows this year. We have Frankenbricks Lab, where you get to build slime and interact and help bring the monster to life. We have the Witchettes that are returning.
Other than Legoland, is there any other entertainment besides for Brick or Treat?
Besides the entertainment here in the park at Legoland California Resort, you can go to Sea Life Aquarium, and we have entertainment in our hotels this year on Friday nights and Saturday nights the Castle Hotel and the Lego Hotel.
That's awesome.
That's awesome.
Brick or Treat is all about interaction and being creative, so we have other activities like the building activity in Heart Lake where you can build pumpkins or ghosts or whatever your imagination creates.
So what are some classic rides to ride?
Well, everybody's favorite this season is Coast Cruise, which transforms into Ghost Cruise. Yes.
If people want to get tickets to Brick or Treat, how should they find out about it?
So you guys can go to Legoland.com and it'll have all the information about the event and the tickets.
How long does it run?
Brick or Treat is the last Saturday of September and every Saturday in October, and it is from 5 o'clock to 9 p.m.
Well, Julian, it was so great talking to you, but it's 8:03 and we gotta run because we gotta hit those three last.
Oh, yeah, you guys know.
Yeah, we gotta hit those three last stations
in
only 1 hour left.
Yeah. You only have 1 hour left. You guys gotta get to it.
We gotta go.
Thank you so much.
Bye, girls. Thank you.
This is like the greatest.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Woo, candy, candy, candy.
To be on the new show here at Legoland.
This is Dr. Frankenbrick. We're gonna be learning from him.
Oh, we have some scientists right here. Let us start by diluting our polymer. That's why they're gloves, go ahead.
Just hold your hands, you got two of them.
Here we go.
So we just got out of the Frankenbrick show and in eight minutes, the park closes. You guys, go, go, go. Right here, come on.
Do you guys have any candy left?
No, we ran out. Sorry about that guy.
Okay.
We just passed by the cliff one and they were closed down. So let's just say that pretty much counts as it because we passed by it.
We can do it.
Oh my God, I'm really scared. I don't think they're gonna have it. I don't know. Trick or treat.
Trick or treat.
Yay.
Can I have some Sweetest Fish, please? I love Sweetest Fish.
What do you want to do?
Thank you.
You got two handfuls? So guys, that was our last one. We literally did all 16. I'm so proud
Me
of
too.
Us.
Me too.
Oh my God.
We're gonna have time for maybe one more roller coaster. Let's go, let's go.
Another year, another Brick or Treat. We did it.
We got lots of Halloween candy tonight. Let us know in the comments section below what is your favorite candy.
And
what will you be for Halloween this year? Let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear about it.
If you want to check out Legoland Resorts or Brick or Treat, head over to Legoland.com for dates, times, and tickets.
Hey, Linda Lee, so did we forget anything, you know?
Well, we can't forget to thank Legoland for having us out again. We had a spooktacular time.
From the Legoland California Resort, I'm Abigail Zoe Lewis.
And I'm Linda Lee Rose. Thanks for joining us.
Have a spooktacular night.
And a happy Halloween.
Have you downloaded our free Attractions Magazine app? It features news articles, as well as every issue of our magazine available right in the app. Plus, catch up on all episodes of the show and even view all of our online videos in one place. Download the app for free in the App Store today.
This week's birthday shout-outs go out to Kenna Pell, Jamie Langdon, Leah Bundy, Irina Pabus, and Kelly Green.
Happy birthday, everybody. The latest issue of Attractions Magazine is out now and packed with all sorts of exclusive theme park stories, photos, and more.
You can pick up your own copy or even purchase a subscription on our website at attractionsmagazine.com/store. Now we want to thank MEI, Mouse Fan, and Universal Fan Travel, our preferred travel agent. For a free quote with no obligation, visit meitravel.com.
And thanks to Undercover Tourist, our recommended supplier of discount tickets to Orlando and California attractions. For more information, visit undercovertourist.com.
Give Kids the World Village is a nonprofit resort that provides week-long, cost-free vacations to children with life-threatening illnesses and their families. To learn more about how to get involved, visit gktw.org. All right, so we've got some awesome segments coming up next week. Mm-hmm. Dark Harbor and LA Haunted Hayride.
Spooky segments.
Some more spooky segments, because you know what? You can't get enough spooky spooks this time of year. Right?
You're completely right.
I love it.
Spooky
I love
spooks?
It. Spooky spooks, yeah. Okay. I'm going to trademark it.
Okay,
it's
yeah,
It's going to be a
it.
Thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
It's Elisa's, time for Elisa's spooky spooks.
Doo-doo. I don't know. Okay. Thank you so much for joining us. We hope you'll tune in again next week.
Until then, visit your local attractions, try something new, stay safe, but most of all,
have fun and spooky spooks.